I'm not holding it anymore. You can give me money out of when you know what price you bought them. Yeah. So you don't have to. Alright, we'll get you to do it. But we can't do it. I don't have it. No, I don't have XLM. Hold on, let's see.
Welcome, everyone. Try to be loud enough. If my voice is going down, please scream to go come back. Sometimes on my shitty phone, some advertisements coming up. Sorry for that. Okay. I try to skip it as soon as I can. So, I was talking about the blockchain university for a while here to someone, but I realized the university is not the right word for that, so I changed it quickly to mentor network, because it's focusing more to the point. Because I'm using the university in a lexical form, not in a common form. There was a lot of questions I needed to ask, and more easy in this way. So, blockchain mentor network. These are just notes. There is no white paper yet on these kind of things, just the vision, and I took some notes. So, I want to solve things in my life and in our society life. Our society, it means the Transylvanian secular society in the middle of Romania, what was, we can say, stolen by the Hungarian kingdom, from the Hungarian kingdom. And we have a lot of pressure there, and we're not allowed to use our language, our culture, learn what we really need to learn about our culture, about our language. We have a ruined script, what is more dense than the Latin letters, and we are not able to learn that, and our brain is just going more weak and weak and weak, and from generation to generation the real value of the Hungarian language just dissolving in this international mess. And I'm really love to take it back. And this needs totally new education system where we can learn what we need, not what they need. So I ended up on the blockchain fields, because the blockchain fields allowing us to create amazing things, what we wasn't able to do that, but all of you know that. And I realized we have no people to create these amazing apps. We have great visionaries, we have great marketing team, we have everything to dream and plan amazing system, but we have no coders. And the coders, what we have, they are stuck in some systems, and maybe that most of the time the big companies are paying them for doing nothing and just keeping away them from the real work to change the world. So we know all of this. And in Hungary, we have really amazing coders. But I spent many months to introduce them the blockchain, how it works, why we need to take our focus on the blockchain and these kind of things, without success. I spent many months and I still hear these questions, oh, the blockchain is the black market stuff and just money and you know, all of these excuses, and I was totally bored about this. And in a group of blockchain professionals in Hungary, in Dania's office, after a meeting, I asked them, what happening if we are building up blockchain university, helping the coders to escape from the companies, to finally be able to create amazing, life-changing, disruptive work. And they said, okay, let's do it. And this is why I'm here. This is why I'm trying to spread this all over the world. And when I started to focus on this project, everything was coming to me. The place, professionals, the financial solution, how to do it. A lot of people was asking in different forums, where can I learn more about blockchain? So the universe was ordering everything in the right position to be able to do this. And this is continuing. So in the Blockchain Mentor Network, our projects are focused by decentralization.
No signal.
Why it's happening? I don't know. So we are. Okay. This is what happened. I can do this like this. Just I can select from this. But okay. So we want to learn creating real life projects. I really miss that in the school today. And all of the projects what we have in the blockchain mentor network first is education related. So first we need to build an education alternative, a design pattern for the best education. And this is how we can develop ourselves to reach that point where we can share this design pattern to different fields, to go to the school and show all of the teachers we have a different design pattern for the education, who wants it. And I hope a lot of teachers say yes, we want it. Years ago I was researching communities, how they work. Communities from the IT field to the off-grid agriculture society. I was traveling, living with them, doing research. And finally, I found, I can say, the best design pattern to create and sustain a community in a physical level. I really want to start any kind of community from the physical level, from the physical space. Because the reverse from the virtual space coming down to the physical level, it's a bit harder. But it's really easy to spread the physical community to the reality, to the virtuality. And this design pattern is a hackerspace design pattern. So hackerspace design pattern has an evolution more than 50 years from the German radio amateur workshops, some kind of this, and has a really good communication system between hackers. Sure, they know how to communicate, they know how to develop amazing things, they know how to disrupt the world, so they are doing this before the blockchain. So we can say the hacker spaces was there in the disruptive industry before the blockchain appeared. So they know how to create amazing things. I was in the team in the first Hungarian hackerspace group in Budapest. I spent 2 years helping the community to grow, to be able to absolutely self-sustainable and meritocratic and a lot of really amazing topic can fit into that community. And autonomous and bottom-up and decentralized, this is all of these are working well in hackerspaces all over the world. And the hackerspaces have an international community. They are connecting with each other and they are doing their job locally too. So they have a really good network good connections, etc. How to do the blockchain mentor network? Involving the top level professionals, coders, mentors, teachers, designers, developers, everyone who can involve, who is good in something, can develop something on the blockchain to his field, to her field. Because we know blockchain technology can be everywhere, even under the chairs somehow. It's possible. It's really good to have a visionary like David all the time in the group to keep the focus all the time on the main vision on the project. Co-working spaces like hacker spaces is really important. I'm planning to. So we have a space, an alternative institution financed by the EU, starting in this year. Physical place with all of the resources, but they have no teachers, they have no topics.
In Budapest,
next to Budapest, in a beautiful, amazing natural surrounding, so next to the city. We have the best place for it. And I spent 2 days to find it. It was coming so easily. Paradigm shift. My favorite topic. So we need to leave the old patterns behind, we know that. Rewire the brain set totally. And really easy to use to do that using natural patterns. So today the humans in the cities, on the concrete, in rubber shoes, we are not living by the natural patterns at all. This is something fake, something not natural at all. And up on our mountains in Transylvania, there's a lot of villages where the old Vedic culture, living together with the nature and trusting in the nature so they can live totally away from the system, decentralized way, self-sustained way. So we have. Sorry.
Sure,
maybe some
minutes.
Porn is coming up. I needed to destroy the root privilege on the phone. This is what I have now. This is my backup phone. communities up in the mountains living in the right way, and we know, so I am really related to them, so I see how they live day by day, and I can see the same pattern in the cities too, in the civilized culture too. So I was living deeply in the IT field in my childhood. I was totally destroying my body, sitting next to the computer for days without food, without drink. I destroyed totally myself, and there was a clinical death state. And after that, I needed to go back to the nature and heal myself. So, and I went to that deeply, so far. So, I know both sides, how to be in the system, connected into the matrix and living in Zion totally free. And now I'm trying to bring these two amazing worlds together somehow. And we know blockchain is the key. And so natural patterns are really useful for the technology design. one of the greatest natural pattern what we have is the tools. I hope everyone know what tools. No? Okay, I show you some other pictures. Maybe no, I can't now. So everyone in this universe have a torus. Even the human body has a torus. Every cell, every plastic pan have a torus. So torus is an energy field. We can say magnetic field, but the magnetism just is a really small part of the energy spectrum. So the historical energy field, it's more mostly recognized by the magnetic field of the Earth. So what is happening here? The energy is expanding. Energy is expanding and compressing. Expanding, compressing. This is a totally unlimited cycle. And we have a lot of drawings about this, even on the cornfields, and even on ancient structures. So the flower of life, the unlimited sign, the
infinity
sign, yeah. But, many others are trying to tell about this to us, to the future generation, about this energy field. And if we have a problem and it's really hard to find a solution, we just take the problem and put somewhere on the energy field of that topic. And we are creating another torus around it, and we're trying to find which toruses are connected with this, and we see the solution for the problem. This is a really easy to use methodology to find the solution for everything.
Can you elaborate with an example, please?
Oh, yeah.
Problem solution.
Let's see. Just tell me a problem.
Debt cycles. Debt cycles.
I'm dying, reborning, dying, reborn.
No, debt.
Debt.
Debt is in perpetually getting into debt.
Sorry.
Loving people money. Debt.
This is a unnatural pattern.
Borrowing from a loan shark.
So what is happening? Someone have a lot of money. Someone have no money.
Yep.
They are coming to those people who have money and asking for it, and the rich people want something
back.
Something
in return.
Yeah. So this is a circle. This have an expanding pattern and compressing pattern. Where is the expanding pattern?
The rich
getting
richer.
Okay. It's perfect. The rich gonna richer. So the rich people are going closer to the center of the torus because they frequency, the energy field is getting dense and dense. And if the energy it's more dense, it's more focused, it's more energetic, we can say that. And the poor people is on the almost at the edge of the torus. So normally, the better solution, so the better for the poor people, to somehow get closer to the center. This is why they need money, because they believe, oh, I can go there if I have more money. But his energy field, his frequency, basic frequency, is frequency. Was developed, was created when he was at the edge of the torus. So for him to reach the center or go close to the center, they need to change the whole surroundings. So they need to make a big step closer to the Taurus. If I'm asking, as a poor people, money from the rich to be able to go closer, step forward, the real solution, if I leave my surroundings, my poor surroundings behind, and I go to closer to the city center where rich people are living. And this can be a solution. But if I stay there on the edge of the Taurus with those people, with the poor people, I just spend this money for alcohol or drugs and that's it, and then stay there without moving forward.
Okay.
This can be an answer for
I like the thinking.
Yeah.
And this is because I see the energy field of this. And we can use this for everything. The energy it's floating not in circles in a helix way, in spirals. So expanding and closing, but doing like this. And even the planet. Oh, I don't want to go inside. Okay. Back to the.
I like the soundtrack.
Soundtrack.
Yes.
What kind of soundtrack?
When you're doing the music, you can.
Yeah. Oh. Thank you. I realized that. Yes, in the nature we have patterns what are easy to use on different fields, so like open source. In the nature everything is open source, so the resource is there, you can go there, you can change it, you can use it. It's normal. So now we have this in the technology field too for a while. Effective human resources. We have a lot of human resources. They are productive, but not effective at all. People are working in the factory, doing the same job day by day. It's bullshit. You know that. And we want effectiveness. And for this, the education system should be effective too. This is why we are using real live projects to learn, not just sitting there listening. And meritocratic workplaces, meritocracy. Who knows what's meritocracy? Okay, meritokratos, merit. Who's worthy for it? I say right? Okay. Kratos is the nation, is the system, is the society. So in a meritocratic system, in a meritocratic society. The leaders are the people who is merito, who have great skills, who is working, who is doing. I learned this in the hackerspace. So in the hackerspace, I spent months sitting there and watching these people doing great jobs, and I wasn't able to fit there somehow because. My brain always was just rolling and trying to find a solution, but without any kind of effectiveness, any kind of productivity. I was drawing beautiful logos for the project, but I never started the project. So one day, guys say, okay, here is a project called Burn Station Project. Burn Station is a physical terminal for Creative Commons music, like a offline torrent terminal in an offline world.
Burn Station,
yeah, it's a Brazilian open source project. It's amazing, and they said, okay, maybe you like it. Yes, I like it really well. I spent a whole month planning how I do this one day, and I had the beautiful logo and beautiful, amazing description and everything what was needed from my point of view to be able to, to create this amazing thing. And one day, Steff was asking me, where the project is going? And I said, I have these. And he said, no, this is not the way how we are doing this. And he was taking a, oh, I need to show you. he was taking out a scooter. He was putting inside a computer with a monitor and workstation 1.0. It's done. We need some software, some cables, and these kind of things. But that can be the development. But the first prototype version is done. And this is how I learned, this is the point, if this is the main point of the meritocracy. I need to do something in a physical level to be able to create something. Just thinking about it, it's worthless. Our brain are
in a way, that kind of relates to what Giles was saying the other day about agile.
Yeah.
Little blocks.
That's it.
Moving multiple directions.
So here's the burn station. Now this is an older version. This is the GUI. Burn station.
Yes.
Is it a one?
Yes, wow. Mate. Old
it's alive. It's alive stuff.
It's alive.
It's alive. And after that, the paintings, the logos, and the whole process, and burning the first CD, and decorations, and everything else, and I'm working on it hardly in the hackerspace. And finally, we are going to the International Creative Commons event organized by the CEO and politicos and bullshits. First music on it, and everyone loved it. And so, this was the great. This was how I learned what is meritocracy. Just take that hammer and hit that. What you are hitting?
Nail
in the wall, and that's it. That's the first step to do something. And in the education system, this meritocratic pattern is really needed. And sure, if we are incentivize the education, we know a lot of great tools for that. Cryptos and tokens and everything what we have, and Steam is doing well the job, so we have a lot of resources to do that. Incentivize learning, learn by teaching, Torica mentor network, the Torus pattern can be network map. So in a system where we can live in a harmonic way, we have that we are connecting with each other, and to make it clear what is the connection between us, it's really easy to see that the connection when we are putting ourselves on a network map, a three-dimensional network map, like a torus. Like I say, the poor people, the rich people. So on every field I have position in a torus. So in coding, that I was a coder a few years ago, I was in the middle of the torus somewhere. I was close to the middle. But today, it's really far from me. I remember the JavaScript and these kind of things, but I'm more close to the edge now in the coding. But I'm really close to the center in a medical healing, natural healing stuff. So our positions in a society map is always changing. It should be dynamical, and the virtuality is perfect for creating this map. And using the Torico mentor network can give us a lot of understanding about our position in the system, how we can affect others in the system, what is the closest relation between people, how can we connect with each other to work on something. This historical mentor network can reveal us a lot of amazing things. What some people can feel in the physical level without technology. But today, we are technology related, we are using these tools, and it's better to have the same pattern through the technology. And we can expand ourselves to nations with this. And tokens, man tokens, just to play mentor tokens, playing with the words. So, these tokens should be dynamic. Should be multi-chain compatible and easy to access. It is easy to access is the key point, I think, because a lot of people not using blockchain and decentralized stuff because it's too hard to use those technology, and we have no real easy to use security stuffs and crypto payment stuff and these kind of things. A lot of people are trying to do the best, but we are really far from that. And the Pillar project stream, just having one screen and you can do everything, this can be a really good starting point. If we have coders for it. So, blah blah bullshit. Yeah. Mentors can earn tokens. Mentee, the padawans, the students, can pay for it. Professionals can work for it, and the mentees are going to be a professional one day. So first I'm paying for these tokens. These tokens are allowing me to involve in the this education system. So I need tokens to be able to be in the system. And I can buy, I can earn, I can crowdfund, or I can reach those tokens as I want. Minos, Tuwares can, that some, if the mentee going to be a professional and coming to be a Mino with this and growing to a whale, well, I don't know what I'm saying right, but you can read it.
Yeah.
And then they can reinvest their tokens to their educational system to make it more and more big and spread all over the world. And the users can, so the in this case, the people who are watching the stream or something can pay as you go, so micropayment and donations and these kind of things. And whales, government, education, NGOs, only donation, nothing more. In the hackerspace design pattern, there is a really strict role. Thank you. There is no. So we are accepting only donations without asking return, because we need to be independent, and this is the main goal, main goal. So I want to implement this. Incentivize publishing, contributing, feedbacks, feature requests, sharing, or name it. What do you want to incentivize in this education system? Classes, just a few examples. Smart words. And thank you for the Wolfram for language. That should be on the list. So, teaching the people how to use Wolfram Alpha. That's a really important key point of education. Thank you for that. You're amazing. And smart words. It's another great technique. I have a mentor who was planning the amazingly beautiful Harmonic Society more than 30 years. And he tried to share with people publicly and in close group, but without success, because they are just stuck in the mind. They love to sit down and talk about this, and at the end of the session they are hating the government and everyone, the whole capitalist realm, and they go home, and next day when they meet, they start this again and again, and they are stuck in this cycle without any kind of result. So I revealed to them, this is a small group, I revealed the blockchain technology to them. They loved it. So first they always hated it, disgusting thing. Then a few weeks later, it's interesting, what is that? And after a month I was able to talk with them. We want to create the whole, so the guy is in, is that country where everything is digitalized?
Estonia.
Yeah. The guy today is in Estonia to create words. Not a company, not a foundation, something bigger.
Non-profit corporation?
Non-profit, but where even organizations can be in that
fundation?